Cool. Yeah, definitely.
Yeah. But yeah, I thought this looked really, really fun. Got my coffee grounds ready.
Oh, good.
Quite a lot.
And it's funny too, you don't need a ton, so.
Well, that's fine. We get them for free, as we make so many coffees with our beloved espresso machine, so they're just there.
Oh, that's great. Okay, so do you have instant or do you just have like regular coffee grounds?
Regular, just from beans.
Okay. And have you steeped them at all, like to get some of the color out of it or anything?
Yeah, they've already been brewed. We've had our coffees and we just dump them into the little knock box.
Okay. All right, wonderful.
Hopefully that's all right.
Oh, that's loud. Gonna have some music for us, but that got really loud. Okay. Okay, wonderful. Well, we're gonna I have instant, so it's gonna be a little bit different, but that's totally fine. And you can use also your markers and if you have a pencil, if you have like a couple sharpies or anything like that. The pencil is really great to kind of mark out your picture just to give yourself an idea of where you're going with everything. So if you have a pencil, that's great. And then, like I said, if you have any sharpies or any kind of black like markers, it's kind of fun to mark at the end. You don't have to, but it's kind of fun to get some of those details in at the end. So with your grounds, what you want to do is, I haven't worked a whole lot with the actual grounds, just mostly with the instant, but what you want to do is you want to get a few shades of coffee. So you want to get your deepest, which would be less water with your grounds. You just want to get as deep as you can. And I would assume you're probably gonna need maybe some hot water. I don't know if you've already done this yet or not, but just to get like three or four cups, and you can put your different shades in each cup. So you're gonna have a really nice dark, deep shade, and then kind of a medium, and then your lightest shade. And again, you're gonna just kind of play with the balance between your coffee and the water. And try and steep as much of the color as you can out with it, but just use less water as you want a deeper color. So,
Okay, yeah, I haven't done this before, so I've only got like a cup full of water at the moment, so I might need a few more.
yeah, no problem.
Yeah,
No problem. And then, yeah, just grab a few cups, like I said, just anything. If you have a little tray, that's fine. If you have some cups, that's good too. I'm gonna mix mine, but again, it's gonna be a little bit different just because it's instant. It's gonna dissolve a little bit more. So I think with the grounds, you can keep the grounds in there, but obviously you just wanna try not to get the ground pieces on your brush as much. You're gonna wanna kind of try and use just the water from it. So but I have my I'm just gonna put my instant in there. And then I'll show you what I have. And maybe you can try and match it with the grounds as much as you can. So you can see, like, I've got one on the edge here that's kind of pretty watery. And then I've got one that's a little bit thicker. It's still pretty watery, but it's just a little bit thicker. And then the last one is pretty thick. So as close as you can get to having kind of a pretty thin one that's watery to having kind of a deeper, thicker color. And then let me know, let me know if I can help you like with anything, but if you have any questions, but let me know if you feel like you've gotten to that place where you've got like kind of three different colors, and then we can move forward and get started on stuff. And we'll have to pick a picture because Daraja said that you that there wasn't really a picture dedicated to this. So I have a few and you can just pick which one you like. Now this one is a lot of fun. I love this one. It's probably my favorite, just a cup of coffee. It's pouring over the monuments from DC, but you could make, you know, any monuments that you want. Like if you wanted to do monuments from London, or if you, you know, wanted to do monuments from, I don't know, any major cities anywhere would be totally fine. But it's just kind of this coffee mug and it's pouring out over top of, you know, some buildings, which is the city, which is really cool. That one's a lot of fun. And then also have, it's kind of mountain scene. Just kind of like a coffee mug ring with some splatters, and then it's got the mountain scene with some trees. That one's really nice and pretty. And I actually had one of those too, that I just kind of did some of the Sharpie detail with, which is kind of, it just to kind of show what you can do with the Sharpie. You can kind of fancy it up a little bit or do some of the details, which is kind of fun. And then the last one I have is this one, which got the little tree in the background, tree in the front, a little bit of water in the lake and some rocks on it. So you feel free to pick whichever one you'd like to work on, because I will do any of them. Kate, what do you do?
Sorry?
What do you do? Do you work during the day, or do you have?
Yeah, I work full time. I'm admin in a mental health team.
Oh, wow.
Yeah, and then in my spare time, I mean, obviously, creative stuff just makes life worthwhile, doesn't it? So I like to do this kind of thing, and I'm a writer, and I'm no artist, though, so I don't really know what I'm doing here. And you don't expect like a masterpiece.
No, it's just, you got to do those creative outlets to, you know, just kind of give yourself some peace of mind, you know. It's just nice to get that side of your brain going.
Yeah, definitely. I feel like loads of workshops have come out of the whole lockdown situation. Like there's just so many more online things available, which I think is really nice.
There really is. It's been so fun to see people just kind of get creative with how to do all these like at distanced, and just kind of still try and have a good time and get creative and be together, because it's obviously it's so hard to just be together with people right at the moment. So that's really neat. Well, thank you for working in healthcare.
Oh, you're most welcome. Do you usually do this kind of thing in person?
Yeah, the coffee art is kind of new. We haven't really, that was kind of one of the things that sprung from more of the Zoom kind of atmosphere, just trying to find some different things to do. But I did a lot of acrylic, you know, painting with Daraja and did the in-person classes. So we had something called paint night, and you would go to local restaurant, and we set up at the local restaurants, like we set up all the paints and all the equipment, all the brushes and everything that you would need. And then you would go to the restaurant, and you could have dinner and hang out, and then you'd paint a painting. So we got a lot of ladies nights out of that. A lot of ladies like to go out with their girlfriends and just hang and have, you know, have some wine, have some dinner, and then paint for a while. So yeah, they were live for a really long time. And then as this happened, we were like, well, we could still do this. Just do it in an online platform. So yeah. We've been doing the painting still. Yeah, absolutely.
It's always nice to have a night out, but doing something a bit different like that is really special, I imagine.
It really is. Yeah. A lot of people just had a really good time with it. And it's still, you know, it's still, obviously it's still fun online, but you kind of, you know, of course we're all missing that aspect of gathering together and, you know, breaking bread and having that time where you get to just kind of chill and hang out with each other, but it'll happen again.
It will. Sometimes.
It definitely will. But yeah, so we've been doing the coffee art, which is new, and I really love it. And we've also been doing some flower arranging classes, which are also a lot of fun. And then obviously we still do the acrylic painting and stuff like that. So it's been pretty good.
Yeah, I must admit this did grab me, and I do love my coffee. And if I can, mm-hmm. I can paint with coffee grounds, perfect.
It's so fun.
Yeah, we get through so many coffees in a day. When we just moved into this place, before we even had a couch or anything, we bought a coffee machine for like 400 quid. So that was our first. It's like, right, we don't have a bed or a couch, but we have a coffee machine, and that's all that matters.
And we're fine with that.
We're fine. We're buzzing and we're fine.
That's so funny. Yeah. I would, same thing. We're like, the old coffee machine goes, I mean, you don't waste any time. You go get a new one.
No time to waste. So what made you think of the coffee art thing?
You know, it became it was already an online thing. I wish we had come up with it ourselves, but it was already kind of a thing that people were doing on Pinterest and stuff like that. So we're like, we're just going to run with that, and started kind of creating our own, you know, pieces to teach and share. And there's just a lot of fun.
Yeah. Jump on board. Why not?
Yeah.
Question though. I've got just like a normal sheet of paper, but I've also got a canvas. I'm not quite sure if it's prepped. It feels a little rough. Which one would you recommend?
I'd probably say the paper is going to work best. The canvas is just, it's better for more surface mediums. This kind of, because of the coffee and of course the water, it just seeps into your canvas. I'd say the paper would probably work a lot better than the canvas would. So,
but I have a third option.
What'd you got?
Watercolor paper in a pad.
Oh, absolutely. If you have watercolor paper, that's going to be the best.
Okay.
Definitely. I'm on it. Absolutely. Because this is essentially watercolors. It's just watercolor with coffee. So.
Okay.
Yeah.
Here we go.
Yeah,
I don't know why I didn't think of that before. What a fool.
That's perfect. Yes. And did you have a pencil with you too?
Yes.
Okay, wonderful. Well, we can start on the outline. If you are you still waiting for your chronic coffee to get a little richer in color, or are you good?
I think it's okay. I mean, we just have to try it out, I guess.
Okay, perfect. And which painting did you want to try out?
Are you going to show them again?
Yeah, absolutely. So here's the tree, and it's got the little house in the background, little water up front. And then got this one, which kind of looks like a, you know, coffee mug ring. And then you've got the mountains and the trees on the outside. And then we've got this one, which has got the coffee mug spilling out coffee all over the city. And this is, like I said, it's DC skyline, but you could do any kind of building outlines that you wanted, any city or whatever that you wanted to do. So.
Oh, they're all so good. I might try the first one.
Yeah, the tree with the water and house and everything. This one?
Yes, please.
Perfect. All right, so just so we can look over it just for a second, because what we're going to do with the pencil is you're going to lightly kind of outline, just so you have a good take on where everything is going to be, and so that you can use your watercolor to kind of color in those lines. So that's what we're going to use our pencil for. But just so we have an idea first, you've got a few, like a little group of rocks over here. And this tree is really just kind of gripped onto the top. The roots are just kind of trying to dig into the top of that rock. It's growing off the top. And then you've got some water here running past the rocks and the tree. Got a little bit of land that we're gonna keep right there with a path down to the river, and it's just got this cute little house, maybe a little barn, I don't know, barn on the side. I don't know what that little extra house is, but there's an extra house back there. And then a few trees and a nice little happy little bush sitting next to the house. So we're gonna outline this, and I'm going to do it pretty dark just so you can see it on the screen, but keep yours like very light, because what happens in the end is you might have a couple little areas of pencil that you want to get rid of. You know, they might just be outside the lines a little bit. You just want to kind of get rid of those lines, and you're going to do that at the end, and you don't want to have to press real hard into your paper. You want to be able to just kind of lightly erase those lines. So keep it light, but like I said, you're gonna see me kind of digging in just a little bit, because I wanna make sure you can see what I'm doing on paper. You won't be able to see it if I go too light.
Okay.
So, but yeah, what we're gonna do is just kind of outline that so we have a place to start. So that group of three rocks is starts about halfway to the middle of the page here, but it's over here on this left corner. And so you can just kind of sketch out your first rock. It's not any kind of solid line or anything. You know, you can make it nice and wobbly, just something for that tree to kind of perch on. Again, make that nice and light. You're just kind of sketching that out a little bit so you can see where you're going. And there's kind of a second little rock here, and maybe another one right below it. And then the water is kind of about halfway up this big rock. I'm going to go ahead and make a line. This is where our water is going to be. And then our land is going to start up here, maybe towards the top of this rock. That's the land piece there. And then we've got our water down here. Feel good about that?
Yeah.
Okay, perfect. Okay. All right, so now we're gonna just kind of see where our tree is gonna go. it's kind of leaning towards the center here. And again, we're shooting to not go too far past that kind of center line of our paper. We want the branches and stuff to kind of come out to this spot, but we want to leave enough space for our house and our trees over here. So we're shooting about halfway. So I'm going to start just at the top of this rock, just kind of drawing out that first trunk of the tree. And again, it's kind of shooting off to the side there. And I'm going to give, I'm going to erase a little bit, but don't erase on yours yet. If you erase first, you're going to maybe see some pilling when you do your coffee. So we're going to wait to erase any of those lines afterwards, but I just kind of got mine a little too far along. So, but yours are nice and light, so you'll be able to erase those later. I'm going to reach a branch over off of this side. And you can kind of make some Y shapes off of there, but not too many, because we'll keep playing with that, but you don't need to sketch out each and every piece. We're just giving it an idea of where everything is going. And then another branch coming off this direction. Again, I'm kind of giving a little Y shape maybe at the end of that. And then another Y shape off the top there. So maybe like three sections of those Ys kind of coming off the top of the tree there. And then I'm gonna put my little house way over here on the right side on this top line that we did for our land piece right here. So we're gonna just get a little square started there, and then we're gonna put that little roof on the top, very stick figure like. And again, just nice and light, keep your sketch nice and light. And then maybe just a smaller, that little guest house or barn or whatever that is over on the side there. I'm gonna draw out just my door, nice long rectangle there, and maybe a couple windows. Make sure you can see everything good. And then we've got kind of that little bush right next to the house. You can give it the little base there. I don't know if you want to kind of scribble out just a little bit of the leaves is fine. Whatever, you can just leave the trunk there if you want. We're just giving it a place to live. And then I'm going to draw a little tree trunk right here. Separate a little bit from that one and do a taller one here. And then right next to that one, I'm gonna do my last one. And again, it's just kind of placing the trunks. They're gonna go taller than that with the leaves and everything, but I'm just kind of giving them a place first. And then from the door, I'm gonna give a little path down to the river. So it's small up at the top where the door is, and then you're gonna come down and get wider at the bottom. Now, your sketches are super light. That's exactly the way that it should be. Again, try not to erase anything, but if you didn't like exactly where your line ended up, just paint, use your paint to go where you want it to go. If you wanted to curve your path out a little bit, you could go past your line and, you know, whatever you want to do that changes it up a little bit. And then at the end, after your painting has dried and everything's good, you can take your eraser and just kind of lightly get rid of any kind of lines that you left behind. So don't worry too much about like staying inside of your lines. It's just to give you an idea of where you want everything to land. And if you want it to look different than what you just sketched, that's totally fine. You can move it just a little bit with the watercolor. And again, like I said, at the end, you can just erase any of those light little sketch marks that you made. Yes, ma'am.
I might need to mix my things again before we do the coffee, just because I didn't know it was meant to be warm water, but obviously that makes sense. So the grounds are not dissolving.
Okay. All right.
Awkward for me, but
It's totally fine. Yeah. It's totally fine. Let me know when you're ready to move on, and we can. Whenever that is, you let me know.
Should I remix them now or after we've?
Yeah, because we're gonna get started on those the actual coffee part. So if you want to remix them now, yeah, that'd be perfect. So just let me know when you're good. I'm gonna turn up some music so you can listen for a bit, and just let me know when you're good. And I'm here.
Thank you.
Yeah, of course, no problem. I might grab another cup of coffee though.
Oh, please do. I get it.
Just hurt inside. Need a song. still some in there.
I know, sorry.
I didn't know. I know. I just, I'm telling you, like, I didn't pour that out and it's beautiful.
Hey, I'm ready, but no rush.
Oh, okay. No, you're great. Perfect. All right. Fantastic. Okay, so what we're gonna do is we're gonna kind of work back and forth with some of these different depths of our coffee. And you two figure out like where you like to have some of those deeper parts. We're gonna start with the lighter. I'm gonna kind of get my big brush here, but use whatever brush you're comfortable with, because I'm gonna fill this rock in first. And what I like to do sometimes with that, I'm gonna take my lightest color. I'm gonna start to, at the very top, and I'm gonna start pulling it down. And as I get closer to the bottom, like I'm working with my lightest, but I also like to make it lighter as it goes, as it gets closer to the bottom. So right about here, I might just go ahead and stick my brush in the water and continue. And as you can see, it just gets a little bit lighter and gives it a little bit more of a fade as it goes down. Although you could bring that same darker watercolor of your coffee all the way down if you like that too, but I don't know. I think it's fun to kind of have that fade going. There are sounds in my head. A little I should go and this should end. But when I found myself and so the really watery one dries fairly fast. I mean, it's still a little bit wet, obviously, but it dries fairly fast. The one thing you want to just kind of be conscious, are you right-handed or left-handed?
Right.
You're right-handed. Okay, so one thing, and we'll go from the left more to the right just to avoid like setting your hand in something that's drying. So I'll try and kind of keep us on that because I'm right-handed as well. So I'll kind of keep us on a left to right, but just something to be conscientious of, especially as you get to the darker colors that don't dry as quickly. They will, they'll stay a little bit wet longer because you've got more of the coffee in them. And sometimes if you set your hand in it and then move your hand somewhere else, then you picked up coffee and you've set it somewhere else that you don't want it to be. So just something to be a little bit mindful of as we go through.
So can I be completely honest with you?
Yeah.
So obviously I've never done this before, but this mixing is not happening for me. So I've got like coffee grounds on my paper.
Oh.
And like the color's not coming out and it's just like littered with coffee grounds. So I don't think I'm really getting this whole mixy ratio situation.
Yeah. Do you happen to have like watercolors with you?
I don't, and I'm using shot glasses. I don't know how appropriate that is.
Yeah. No, I think that's probably pretty good because you've got, you know, you don't need a ton of any of these. So a shot glass is probably perfect, but
I mean, I've got the color. It's not the end of the world. I've just got some color in it.
Well, and I wouldn't worry too much about that either, because I feel like once your painting has dried, those coffee grounds will probably lift off anyway. So as your painting is kind of drying, you could potentially be, you know, just kind of brush off some of the grounds that are sticking onto your brush. It just might leave, but, and this isn't a bad thing, but it might leave, you know, the small where like it kind of gets a little concentrated where the grounds are sticking. The longer they sit there, the more you might have some spots of deeper color because your, you know, your grounds have sat there. So I don't know, it might kind of leave a cool texture, which is not a terrible thing.
It's maybe happened for a reason. So let's see what happens.
Yeah, I kind of feel like, see, if it's not bugging you too much, then yeah, I would keep, see what happens. Yeah, for sure.
Let's ride with it.
You could also like just try, if you have like a sieve or something you could strain the grounds out with, then maybe that would get rid of your grounds and then you won't have to worry about them quite as much if you have anything like that.
I feel like you're right though. I feel like they would probably just brush off at the end.
Yeah. As it dries, I think they're just probably going to brush off. But like I said, it might leave a darker stain like where those were sitting. But if you're getting good color out of them, then yeah, then that's probably going to be fine. And as that dries, you know, this area, even if I went back over this part that I just did with that lighter color, it's going to darken it up a little bit. So it might be that if you don't have like a really rich, deep color with any of them and you want to get a little bit darker, let your paper rest, like give it a little bit of time to dry and let it rest. And then you can go back again, even with the same color, and deepen up some of those areas. It might be after, you know, after a few hours, you know, just letting it sit and rest. But if you're finding you want to go back in and just kind of deepen up some colors, if you're not getting the result you want, then you could certainly do that. Okay. If you have a good, like, second, like deeper color, I'm going to use that. So I'm going to kind of go like number one is my wateriest, like number one is my wateriest. Number two is like this, the middle one, the second shade there. And then number three, just so I don't kind of give them a name, one, two, and three there, just so you know where I am. So I'm going to go two, which is my middle. And I'm going to just get this tree filled in. So whatever you have that kind of gives you a little bit of a deeper color. And like I said, if you need to let things dry and then go back in, that'd probably be good too, either way. So I'm taking that second color. I'm gonna kind of get most of my branches filled out. And I'm also going to start to just shape my roots that are kind of digging into the rocks a little bit as well. And I'm just pulling down, I'm doing the same as I did with those branches, just making upside down Y shapes. Instead of going up, I'm just going down with those little Ys. I'll lift it up just a little bit. Don't mind my pencil marks. And the other thing, like I said, that's cool too, is at the end, giving it some detail with some of the markers might be the way to go too. If you're not getting, you know, the depth of color that you want, you can kind of use a marker.
I feel like my paint pens are going to be a bit of a lifesaver with the detail.
Yeah, there you go. Perfect.
Perfect. Just out of interest, would this work with like, you know, loose leaf herbal tea, how sometimes you get like pinks and blues and everything?
I had someone try that with I haven't done it yet. I keep thinking about it though, especially like because that raspberry tea, you get that nice like kind of pink reddish kind of color come from it, and I always wondered how that might work with like some flowers, like if we were doing cherry blossoms or things like that. So I think if you, again, you would have to steep it in a like a lot less water so you could get more of a concentrated color and really just kind of let it sit and get as deep as you can get it. But I don't know. I think it would work. Yeah. It definitely wouldn't give this as deep of a color as the coffee does, but I think it would work.
Yeah, I might try that.
Yeah, I think it would be kind of cool.
You could run like a herbal tea arts workshop.
Yes, exactly. I've got to figure it out first, but yeah, I think that would be a lot of fun. I have to go buy some and test them out. I mean, I have some here, but most of the ones that I have seem to not have a lot of color in it. So I'll have to go try out some other ones.
Do you know what's really good? Have you heard of Bird and Blend Tea?
I don't think so.
No, they're in London and they're online. But they're incredible and they're sustainable and everything. They deliver internationally as well. So maybe check them out.
Bird and Blend,
yeah.
Okay, that's good to know. I love teas, so that'd be perfect. All right, so I've got my tree shaded in. I've got this first rock. I'm gonna take that second color as well, that middle one, number two, and I'm gonna fill in that back rock there. And I think I'm going to do the same where I like start with my color up at the top and then kind of dip my brush in water and then pull the rest of it down so it just lightens up a little bit as I go further down. I don't know, it's kind of fun to just even play with that technique just to see, you know, kind of get an idea of how that works. It's a lot of fun.
For everything your clothes go through, there's Tide Hygienic Clean. With deep cleaning power, it removes visible and invisible dirt.
You want to learn the worm?
But it's dirtier than it looks. Try new Tide Hygienic Clean.
For great savings, buy Tide Hygienic.
And I'm going to take number three, my darkest, and I'm going to fill in that rock that's that third one. Just get that one done. All right, being mindful again, just those are still wet. So just as you're working up in the top tree, just watch your arm and your hand so you're not dipping in what's wet there. I'm gonna go back to my number one color and I really wanna make, so what I'm gonna show you this tree again, this first one. So we're essentially using those really light stains to kind of those back leaves back there, that just kind of the shadowy area of these back leaves. So I'm gonna just use that light color to just kind of start splotching around these areas. And you're gonna see, there's no tree branches really attached. I mean, I have a few later on that I'm gonna detail in there, but right now I'm just gonna be making these splotches because it's implied that there's a branch going to each one, even though you can't see the branch. So don't worry about like trying to match on the branches that you already have on there. We're just gonna make some coffee splotches in these areas. And then we can fill some branches in a little bit more when we get to some of our details. But we're gonna start with that really light coffee in the back there and get some splotches. Again, I'm gonna start with my number one, my lightest. And I might, you know, every once in a while dip my brush in my water as well, just to get even a little bit of a lighter stain. So right around the end of this Y branch here, I'm just gonna start making some splotches around there, some big, some small. I'm just using the side of my brush and just kind of dabbing around there a little bit. I dipped it in water just to get some lighter stains going. So really I've just got this like kind of almost like a bush at the end of this branch here that's just light splotches of color. And I'm going to do that again up here. No rhyme or reason to where they're going, really. Just kind of move them around. Don't make it too methodical, you know, just get some different splotches going around there. You don't want it to be even or, you know, spaced the same or anything like that. Just kind of move it around and let it land where it lands. And then another, our last like kind of group. And again, I'm a little over the halfway point, but I don't want to get too close to my trees. I mean, it's okay if you do, but you know, I'm just trying to give everything a little bit of space. So it's, this tree is kind of our focal point. So we want to have, these are going to kind of be our background trees. And we'll do that mostly with this lightest stain anyway. So they will be in the background. I wouldn't worry about it too much, but I just so you see, I am like, here's my halfway point. I have a little bit over the edge, but I'm staying mostly on this side with that. All right, I'm going to take my number two, my middle one. And I'm going to kind of do the same thing around those same areas. I'm not going to go exactly on the same spots, but I am going to end up kind of on top of some of those areas. But I'm going to do the same thing, kind of ignoring what's already there and making these darker splotches. And I'm not filling in all the spaces either. I'm leaving some, you know, leave some white. You don't want to end up with a huge just splotch of color either. So just kind of spread them out a little bit. Some small areas, some bigger, same thing. It's a little bit darker. It might end up being a little bit like maybe just a touch less than what you did in the background there. Maybe we don't want quite as much. God bless you. Thank you. How are you feeling, Kate?
Yeah, good, thanks. I mean, it doesn't look like yours, but...
but it shouldn't. It should look like yours.
It's filling out. I feel like the more I sort of make a mistake, the better it looks in an abstract way. You know what I mean?
Yeah, definitely. Exactly what you mean. That's great.
I haven't actually used a paintbrush in probably years and years. Like,
is that right?
I use sponges instead because the kind of stuff I do when I do like rock painting and stuff, and it just gives me a good even coverage. So it's nice to actually use these paintbrushes that have never been touched.
Oh, that's great. Oh, fun.
And it feels really nice, actually. They're so nice and soft, and it's nice to paint with them.
Oh, good. Yeah, those sponges are great, aren't they?
Oh my God, they're so good.
They're super cheap. They're easy to clean out. They great, like you said, they give great coverage. They're really good. Love them.
Yeah. Especially for rocks.
Yeah, definitely. Definitely. We did do a rock painting class a few months ago. We haven't done one in a while, but
this
past fall, we did one this past fall.
It's so much fun. Like, I just can't believe how fun it is.
They're really fun. Do you hide them around town, or do you just kind of use them as decoration in your...
That was a thing for a while, hiding them around town. And I did hide a few, but then there was this weird thing where loads of people were complaining, like, I don't even know what to say about it, like that they were tripping over them, or they were like a nuisance or whatever. It's like, what? Okay, that's a bit weird.
Wow, that's weird.
I know, but I basically make them as presents now, and I've done like wedding rocks for people and so forth. So.
Oh, that's cool. Oh, that's neat.
Yeah. Do you do it like just in your spare time?
I haven't for a while. We same thing, like we had them around town, like it was a thing a few years ago, and they would actually put them, like they would hide them in shops, like on the shelves. Really? And stuff. Yeah, and then you could go in and you could trade, like you could, if you really liked one, you could take that one but trade for one that you did, or you know, kind of move around. It was just a fun, like the kids loved it. Like I was working in one of the shops down there as a Chandler, and the kids would come in looking through the shop for rocks while their parents shopped. It was so cute.
Oh, and, imagine how exciting it would be for them, because I find it exciting, and I'm 34, so.
Yes, exactly. It was so fun. They would paint it also gave their parents like something for them to do. Like, so they'd like paint their rocks at home, and then they would get really excited to go around town and like kind of display their rocks, the ones that they painted, but also find ones that they really liked and like trade them. And yeah, it was fun.
My secret weapon for rocks is paint pens. Like, they're not cheap, and I have a huge collection, but it's made my life like amazing where rocks are anything's concerned, really. It's just to get that detail, especially if you're not an artist, like, because I wouldn't know how to get that detail with a paintbrush, for instance. So
right, like
my holy grail.
Oh, the pens are great, aren't they?
Do you use Posca?
Yes.
Yeah, they're the best.
Yeah.
I've got like the really fat ones, and then I've got some thin ones. And then my friend recently bought me super, super fine ones.
Oh, like nice.
These teeny tiny ones. I don't know if you can see the tip there. See.
Oh, yeah. Oh, those are great.
So fine.
Good detail, bro. Yeah, definitely. Yeah. I was doing, you know, the plastic, they're kind of almost like really dense styrofoam pumpkins that they sell like every fall at the craft stores.
Yeah.
Have you guys seen the, they Sharpie makes an oil, based marker. And I would take those in like each section of the pumpkin. I would like decorate like in sections, and, and use those markers. And it was, at first I was trying to use like regular paint and stuff, and it was really difficult, but then you get those like little markers and it makes the detailing so much easier. So I'm definitely with you on that.
Like, people are always asking, oh, you know, how do you do this and that? And I'm like, paint pens. Like,
yeah,
that's it. You don't even, that's my only answer. Paint
pens. Yeah, absolutely. They're a lifesaver, definitely.
Yeah.
Okay, so you know what? Let's go ahead. I feel like that's kind of still drying a little bit since it's one of the denser ones. Let's go ahead and go over here and we'll do our lightest number one color here and fill in the tree trunk. I went to a smaller brush because I'm gonna, like I said, first fill in, just kind of fill in, give where your tree trunk's gonna be. And then I'm gonna kind of do something similar to that splotchy kind of paint that we did, but I'm using a smaller brush. It's gonna be a little bit smaller and it's gonna be more at a zigzag as it goes, as we kind of make a triangle. So here, let me show you before you do it.
Please do.
Yeah, I know it's hard to explain, but you're gonna start at the, you know, at the bottom of this tree trunk, maybe about halfway down, leave a little bit of the trunk at the bottom. And then I'm kind of dabbing, I'm gonna make a longer line at the bottom, right? And then it's gonna kind of go at a triangle towards the top. So I'm gonna just kind of take that brush and kind of go a little bit zigzaggy as I go up to a point, right? So I'm just kind of using the very tip of that brush and I'm dotting with it and I'm kind of going back and forth and I'll push this up towards the camera in just a second so you can see a little bit closer. But I don't want to fill it all the way in. I want some of those like white spaces through there just to show that there's some detail. So I kind of, again, back and forth, but I got smaller as I went to the top. So this triangle, long triangle kind of shape. Sorry, I know the pencil is probably super distracting, but it's...
No, it's not, it's fine.
It's distracting me, but...
So, you know, I think mine's going to take a really long time to dry. Like, yours looks almost dry, but mine is still kind of puddles, so...
Is it? Okay, all right. No worries. Again, the biggest thing about that is just to watch your hand and your arm just so you don't dip in it. But yeah, it's totally fine if it takes a while. I know, you know, like I said, is the thicker it gets to, the longer it takes to dry. Like these right here, like really wet still. So
I think it's something to experiment with, like getting the right consistency of mixing next time.
Yeah, definitely. I will say it, the instant coffee, if you have access to like getting some, you know, at the store or whatever, that it does make it easier just because it dissolves a little bit better. And if you, you know, if you want to make it a little bit thicker, you just add a little instant coffee. If you want to make it thinner, you just add a little water. Like, it definitely makes it a little bit easier to just kind of work with.
I feel like you might be on something there because proper coffee, you always get the dregs, don't you? So it's never going to actually completely dissolve, but we don't actually have any instant coffee in the house because we're snobs,
right.
So I can go out and get some.
Yeah, right, exactly. And you know, again, like later, if you end up getting some and you want to come back and put in some of those details, you know, come back, let the paper rest a little bit, let it dry up, and then grab some instant coffee and come back with some of those deeper colors and give a little bit more of a more detail in there. So you can certainly work with the same painting. So I did it again for that middle one, a little bit taller, right? I've got that second tree just a little bit taller. Now this one is right next to this middle tree here. So I'm gonna stay mostly on the left side of this tree going up just because I don't wanna fill in too much of the spaces that I already have there. And it's kind of already implied that it's running into this tree a bit. So I'm gonna I might start a little bit lower, give that long bottom of the triangle there, and then I'm gonna kind of work on this left side as I go up. And then there he is. So you can fill in a little bit, but again, I just don't want it to get too muddy between the two of them. So I work mostly on that left side. And I think I'm going to leave this bush for just a minute so I can work on the house. And I'm going to go with my second color. Or you know what? Actually, I'm going to go with number 3. I'm going to go with the deepest color. But again, you can come back in later and kind of give those deeper tones if you want. And again, your markers are going to be great at the end for giving some more detail. But I'm going to take my number 3, my darkest. I'm going to start at the top here. And I'm going to do that add water thing as I get further down so that it lightens it up a little bit. So now I've got like this dark color at the top and then it's just lighter at the bottom. And I'm just gonna take what's left on my brush and I'm gonna fill in that second house because it's really kind of in the background there. I don't want it to be too noticeable.
Yeah, that's not really working for me. I feel like my, I don't know, it must be too watery or the brush isn't fine enough.
Yeah, so yeah. Then what I would suggest is go ahead with whatever color is coming out, fill the whole thing in, and then after that dries, go back in again at the top to make your deeper color.
My dad's gonna think I'm crazy, but like, say, "Oh, Dad, have you got any instant coffee?" He'll be like, "What happened to your 400-pound coffee machine?" And I'll be like, "I need it for art, obviously.
I need to paint.
I need to paint." He'll be like, "All right."
Okay, I'm gonna take my little bit of a bigger brush, and I'm gonna go with what. I'm going to give you the suggestion. So I'm going to kind of go almost like I have what you have and give instead of like what I have. So it maybe will help you a little bit. I'm going to get my lightest color and I'm also going to dip in water because I really want this to just be kind of faded. I'm going to just go right where the path is and just kind of take that really light color. And I'm not even going all the way to the edges. I'm just kind of right through the path, but not all the way to the ends. I'm just getting right around that area there. Keep it real light. And then when that dries for you, you can go deeper right where the path is. So where I'm taking like my number 2, you would just come back in, like I said, after that dries and just kind of fill in where that path is laying. Mine bled a little bit just because I didn't wait till it dried, but it's fine.
Yeah, that's basically happening with all of mine because there's so much water and so little coffee and it's all together. No, I'm making it sound really terrible, but it's hard to get the
No worries. Yeah, like I said, just wait till it dries and go back in again and get that. And then when you get some instant coffee, you can go back in with some of those darker details.
Definitely.
Yeah. So with the lightest, again, the number one here, I'm just going to, again, some of those, they're going to be bigger zigzag shapes than the tree though. So I'm taking like my medium brush and I'm just going to kind of go through this water area here and just kind of make some zigzag shapes through there. So it's just kind of like that. And then just so you see what it'll look like later when you go back in. So you're gonna let that dry and you're gonna go back over it again with some of those darker colors there. And you can also, again, do some of this with your markers and kind of give it a little bit of detail there too. It's also fun if you want to play around with this, but there's like a little circle kind of ripple, like maybe one of the leaves had fallen off the tree into the water and it kind of gave a little ripple. So if you want to do that like around one of the rocks, then you can kind of make a little half oval shape here, like it's the ripples coming out from there. You don't have to do that, but
don't worry. I mean, it seems like a good idea, but I just see it bleeding into everything. Yeah.
That might be a marker detail that you want to do.
I feel like don't judge me till I've gone in with the Poskas.
Yeah, right, exactly. Do you have some browns?
Yes, I do.
That's cool. Let me see. I actually don't have them up here, but I can show you some, you know, with the some details that you can do with the brown marker. I just have black, so it's going to look a little different, but
you can also go in my collection.
What's that?
Do you mind if I show you my collection?
Oh no, please. I would love to see it.
I want to show it. Let me just go.
Please. I'd love to see it.
So these are my thick ones in here.
Okay. Oh wow, you've got a lot of good ones.
My 5-point ones. And then yeah. These are all my medium sizes, which includes shimmery ones.
Wow.
And then and these are my fine ones.
Those are great.
And then
they keep coming.
These are my super fine ones.
Oh, nice. Wow. You've got a great collection. That's amazing.
I do. I don't want to think about how much
altogether
this has cost me. I'd like to think that I've just bought them as I've gone along.
Right.
It really hasn't been that much of a financial burden.
That's so funny. I totally understand.
I thought you might.
I love it. That's great. Do you have any of your rocks there?
Do I have any rocks that I've done?
Yeah.
I do actually. Don't know if they're some of my best, but let me have a look. Actually, I do have one of my favorites here. I just, I don't really know what to do with it, but like a sea theme.
Oh, that's so cute. And the tail at the bottom there.
It's nice, isn't it? Actually, that's probably my favorite that I've ever done.
I love that. The colors are so bright.
And then I've done this one, but I kind of need a person to have a baby or something because it says delivery on the bottom.
Oh, that's so cute. Kate, those are really cute.
Oh, thank you. And I've got an ice cream here. So it's a happy ice cream on the front.
Cute.
And then it's a sad ice cream.
That's adorable. That's always so fun when you like get one of the shaped rocks and you can kind of look at it and be like, what could this be? And like, it looks like it's shaped like an ice cream cone. Like, that's perfect. I love it.
I know. I was so excited. I mainly thought ice cream. And then I found one time that looked like, it's like in the shape of a kid's like a cartoon car.
And I'm
yes, let's make that like a little red car, like doo-doo, and give it to a child. But I haven't had it
yet. Oh, that's so cute. I love it. Oh, those are great.
Oh, well, thank you for asking.
Yeah, no, I love seeing that stuff. It's so fun. And those are amazing. You do a really good job. Okay, so if you're working with markers, I think that if you have some of the brown markers, that could give you some good detail through your branches. I think because I have black, which would look really bad. I'm just going to show you with the darker paint that I have, the darker color that I have. If you go through, like, so on this one, let me show you this so you can see, like on this tree, you can see some of those deeper. I kind of think with your marker, you could do some of these deeper details in the tree. And also those like extra branches that come out from the top there. And potentially you could also do some of these darker shades on the leaves as well. So if you want to try with your marker,
then, I do want to try, but I think I'm just like going to be putting my marker in wet, to be honest, but I'll see how it goes.
Okay.
And also, I don't know what's happened to my brown, so yeah, just give me a bit of time to get this ink flowing.
Yeah, absolutely.
The color is actually really good. This brown is very, very much the same as the coffee color.
Oh, good. That's great. And again, this is, and two, you can keep playing. Obviously, it's not done when we're done. You can keep playing with that. The markers and more coffee if you want, you know, if you get instant and you want to try some more of that, that's perfect.
Imagine if it was just done, like imagine if everything you created, as soon as you left it was
done. I know.
That would just be awful. Imagine that.
It's like emotion racking though, to leave something and you don't, and it's just like, you know, I'm sure you feel the same when you're doing a piece and you're like, it's just not done yet. I don't know what's missing. You know, it's just, you think about it constantly. What am I missing?
And then there's like the whole, am I going to overdo it?
Right. And yes.
Stop.
Yes. Do I stop here? Yeah, exactly.
Okay, so I can't show you what's going to happen with this marker because it hasn't dried nearly enough and the marker's just going into water basically, so.
Yeah, exactly. Okay, well, let me show you just kind of, I'll kind of step through. Don't feel like you have to do it, but just some things to think about as you get, you know, your paper gets to rest and it's a little bit drier and you feel like you can work with it. I'll just show you some of these pieces and then you can go back in and do it when you're ready. if you take that, that I'm taking that deepest, deepest color I have. I'm going to fill in my windows. I already did my, my little bush guy there. You can just fill that in when you're ready.
Thank you.
It's working from home. I've got my whole family with me. So I'm going to, you know, fill in the door and the window with a little bit of a deeper color just to get that popping out just a little bit. You can also add a little bit of some deeper color at the tops of these trees, just a little. You don't want to overdo the, that too much because they are background trees, but you can add a little bit of details in there. And then, like I said, for the tree, you can start bringing in some of those like little creases and stuff that happen. And kind of pull in some of the roots a little, make them a little bit more, you know, stand out a tad. And then, so you can see just some of those like details for at the bottom of the tree. And then also like up in the top here, you can pull some of these out and make some of these branches a little bit more. Again, it's just a lot of Y shapes. That's a little Y shapes all through there. So when you can make as many
Y shape.
You can make as many or as few as you want. You know, don't go too crazy on them because you don't need a ton of branches. Like I said, it's kind of implied that those branches are there and you don't want to give it too much detail or else it kind of loses that that kind of far away effect that this painting kind of goes for. It's like it's you're not really up that close to it. So you don't want to lose that. And again, you could come back down here in the water and kind of give some of these with that paint pen a little bit more detail, some small little waves or Z, you know, zigzaggy kind of shapes through here. And you can also add, I think on the other one, there's like just a little bit of rock area right next to the path, like down towards the water, just gives it a little bit more detail if you want to add anything like that. And then again, I just had some of these like areas up in the top here that, it, and again, a lot smaller than the first set of foliage we did back there. Just kind of give some small shadowy areas up here. Yeah, and that's pretty much gonna be it. Now again, if you want, you could come back in with a marker. Like a Sharpie, like, you know, the black for outline, and add some extra things in there too, if you want to. If you're going to use the marker, I'd say stay mostly up front. You can give a little bit of detail maybe to the house because that's where the eye kind of draws to, but like the trees and stuff in the background, you don't want to give them too much detail because they are supposed to be so much further in the background. But anything up close, you can give some detail to, with your black marker, but I think you're going to find that once you use your brown marker and you're in there giving those deeper details with the brown, that you're going to like that a lot. And I don't know that you're going to want to mess with any kind of like black outline, at least not in this one. Like some of the other ones, it's kind of fun to mess with that Sharpie, but I haven't found that I've really liked it a whole lot in this one, but you might have some good ideas for that. So
I found a solution to doing it now because I'm really impatient. I've got a glass pen, which I forgot about. So I'm dipping that in some caramel ink, and that's going on just fine. And then I'm kind of just smudging it with my finger a little bit.
Oh, nice. That's
and
great.
And it's actually perfect match in color as well. So.
Oh, that's great. That's good.
Have you ever used a glass pen?
No, I actually have not.
It's really fun.
How is it?
Something about it. It's just like a dip pen, really. And I find that you've got to use good quality ink, because if you don't, yeah. How the F do you write with a glass pen? This is not working. But as soon as you use quality ink, you're like, oh my gosh, it's a miracle.
Oh, wow.
And they're so pretty. They're honestly so pretty. I'll hold it up when I'm done, because it's like a magical little unicorn pen.
Oh, that's so cool.
And I kind of got the same present, the exact same glass pen and inks from two of my partner's family members for Christmas.
Oh, wow.
And I'm thinking, do they not liaise with their gifts? But that's good, because if one breaks, you know, I've got another one. So
yeah, exactly. It's always kind of nice to have a backup.
Yeah, yeah.
Always kind of nice to have a backup. That's awesome.
You can.
Oh yeah. Oh wow.
Yeah, it's gorgeous, and it's like really opalescent.
Oh, it's beautiful.
It's like a unicorn horn, but
it is. That is so cool.
So if you ever want a bit of variety,
I'm definitely like, gonna check into that. That's amazing. Yeah.
And they're not expensive either, so no, I don't really know what I'm doing now.
That's all right.
Yeah, I feel like it's gonna need some, you know. Oh, I don't know what I've done there. No, that's yeah. That was not the right move, but oh well.
No worries. I mean, I think it's something that, you know, you can play with and definitely see what works best.
I feel like it's good for the trees, like the tops of the trees, definitely.
Yeah, yeah. I would imagine.
Yeah, it's been really enjoyable.
Oh, good. I'm so glad. Yeah. And then just the, you know, one of the last things and something I had said in the beginning is just if there's any kind of lines that you want to just make sure your painting is dried up, and then you can just kind of lightly get rid of any lines that you don't want to have on there.
Yeah.
You know, any lines that you didn't hit, like, I don't know, there's like some up here by the tree. Just try and keep it a light erase. Like I said, if you you don't want your paper to pill up too much as you're going through. So yeah, just let everything dry up really well, and then you can go through with your eraser and get rid of any lines that you don't like and want to cover up.
I just realized that I completely missed a tree. You know where the house is?
Huh?
You know the house? Yeah, that one there. I just haven't put it in at all.
You don't even have to put it there if you don't want it. It can go there if you want, but just a little.
I definitely wanted it. So.
Yeah, it's so cute.
Except my tree is like bigger than the house, so I don't think I exactly got the dimensions quite right. Yeah. That's one thing I was never good at, perspective. So there you go.
Oh, too funny.
Oh, easy for you to laugh. You've got it going on.
Well, you know, as the saying goes, there's no accidents. It's only, well, it's happy accidents. No mistakes, only happy accidents. That's what it is.
I like that. I like that.
Yeah.
I think it might go a bit crazy without that saying.
Yeah. Definitely.
Please give me some hope.
I love it.
Well, yours looks lovely.
Well, awesome. Oh my gosh, Kia, it's so fun to hang with you this afternoon. Thanks for doing this with me.
Oh, no, thank you. I really, really enjoyed it. Oh, yeah. Thanks for
I
oh, you look lovely.
It's a morning face. It's like, well, it's 11:30 now, but we started at 10. So.
Mine is a 4 p.m. face.
There you go.
I'll hold mine up, but, you know, it's... Yeah, it is what it is.
How did it go? I like, it looks really good. You did a great job with what you had. Definitely. I love it. And I think that pen adds a lot to that tree. I can see on that left side. It looks really good.
Yeah, I'm glad I remembered that I had it.
Yeah.
So yeah, I'll keep working on that. And you've given me sort of lots of ideas and inspiration carrying forward, you know, of what I can do. So thank you. That was really, really good. And I will be, have you got any others coming up that are similar?
I think so. Just definitely check the website. And, you know, if you want to try some other stuff too, just come hang. It's a lot of fun. We do, you know, check Facebook, make sure you're hanging out there, because every once in a while we'll do like just a live stream where, you know, it's free and open. You can just hop on. And if you have supplies with you, you can paint along or whatever. You know, I always encourage people, like, if you don't have the paints or the canvas or whatever, you can just grab some markers or I don't know, whatever you've got laying around. You've got lots of pens.
Yeah, I do. I feel like you can just kind of do anything, can't you? Like, you can just scribble with a Sharpie and wet your finger and smudge it.
Right.
Do whatever, can't you?
Yeah, absolutely. Absolutely.
Yeah, really great hanging with you, and have an excellent day, and hopefully I will see you soon at some point in another workshop.
Yeah, that'd be awesome. So good to meet you, Kate.
Yeah, you too. Thank you.
All right, have a good one.
Bye-bye.
Bye.